we're gonna throw some crankbaits. And that right there is Yo-Zuri 3DB 1.5 crankbait. What am I gonna throw it on? St. Croix Legend Glass. I got the 7.2 medium power. Now this bait dives down about 4 feet, 4.5. I got 10 pound line, so it cuts through. If I wanted to keep it even shallower, I'd go to maybe 12 pound, maybe 14 pound, but I just wouldn't get that depth that I want. I want that little bill scratching in those boulders and rocks that I'm gonna work on shorelines. The shorelines I'm gonna fish are like a taper, where it's real shallow and stuff, and it just tapers down. There's those lines that the fish travel on. Now it could be somewhere between 3 to 6, 5 to 7, you know, 8 to 10, but it's that little dark edges that they go on. But because this bait dives down about 4 feet, when I'm cranking it, I'm gonna stay in about 7 feet and cast up to about 3.5, 4 feet and bring it down, bring it along that edges. Put some casts up. If I see big boulders along the shoreline, I'm gonna put it up inside there too. Low profile, casting reel, smooth drag, but I gotta tighten right down. So when I set hook, the properties of this rod do not pull that crankbait away from the smallmouth. That's the biggest thing that happens with guys using a rod that's too heavy for crankbait fishing, that when they set hook, they're pulling actually this bait away from the fish when they feel the bite. When the fish bites that crankbait, he has to close his mouth. The sensation of the glass feels it, but you do not pull the bait away. The properties of the rod go, so you can just pull, but they don't pull the crankbait away from the bass. It's very important. So I'm gonna pick some shorelines like the stuff behind me, stay out about a cast length from shore, work those edges with the 1.5 by Yo-Zuri, and hopefully find some smallmouth. Eat it. It's a soft bite, boy. 1.5. Oh boy. Hey. Nice little smallmouth. Just in the side of the jaw too, look at him. Yeah, that rod just leans back when fish has got it. You don't pull that crankbait away from the fish's head. Nice bass too. That Yo-Zuri 1.5. Hey, that crawdaddy color. Come here, you. What I got you, huh? A good sized fish too. Hold on, hold on. Right there, Yo-Zuri 1.5. Crankbait, but you see how I'm working it? Nice and varied, back and forth, not just a cast and crank. Yes, you'll catch bass like that, but this guy, I had just had to pause. No bragger, but it's a start. Crank, 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 and I'm stopping. When I stop, it rises. A lot of times I bet you that's when they're gonna eat it. When they see it, first land, sometimes the first couple of cranks get their attention, and then I stop. It's like a bird dog, this little bait. I make it do all kinds of things. Twitch it, make it move, stop it. The bass notorious for eating crankbaits when you stop them. It's nice when they eat it when you just continually chunk, but sure is nice when you can work it. Okay, as for colors, you know what? I was on this lake a couple days ago and I saw some of the crawfish that they're spitting up. And when they're eating stuff that's orange, with dark red and black and stuff, I just gotta match the hatch. Seriously, even with the crankbait, because I'm working those same areas, cranking along. Something that looks somewhat familiar, it's in my favor. But other options include the sexy shad, something about that spot on the side. It's got that little bit of chartreuse. The water I'm fishing is off color, so I can get away with some real obnoxious colors. But again, I'm working it, cranking, stop, twitching, working like a bird dog, going around, hitting the nose, knocking into rocks and rocking into logs and things like that. Smallmouth are so inquisitive. They see something move, they gotta try to eat it. Another pattern would be the bright chartreuse, again, with the big spot on the side. People say those spots on the side are like a predatory thing, like a target they can zoom in on. The eyes, big eyes, beautiful baits. And the biggest thing about this I like is the hooks are laser. A guy means sticky, sticky. Look at that, I'm barely touching them. And that's what you want with crankbaits, because the smallmouth clamps down, their mouths, the tension they have, the torque is incredible. I'll show you what they look like in the pack. Here's like a chartreuse fire tiger, okay? So it's a 3DB by Yo-Zuri, This is one's called the Prism Chartreuse Perch. One of these colors, either the crawfish, bright red and orange, or the fire tiger perch, or the chartreuse, is gonna help me catch some bass on a sunny, warm day in early summer.
Got him. Whoa, right on that edge, right on that lip. Wow. He liked that crankbait, didn't he? Whew, look at you. Oh yeah. He just flashed at it. I think I got him underneath, look at that. Yeah. Oh yeah. The whole combination, man. The rod, the bait, helps you catch those fish with the crank, boy. Look at you. Nice Ontario smallmouth.
Boy, look at that.
Huh? Oh yeah.
Gotta have them pliers ready.
Got that other hook on the side there.
Sharp hooks, man. Look at that, just a solid, beautiful little football. Beautiful football. As soon as you hit the water, right on that lip, go on you. Beautiful. See, using pliers, you don't have to hurt the fish. But a couple of things you gotta check when you're crankbaiting like that. Take a look, make sure you didn't bait anything out. Look how sticky sharp those hooks are. Wow. Especially with smallmouth fishing. When they come out of the water like that, I tell you, they use all the velocity and power and torque that they have to try to spit a bait. Now you're fishing a stick worm or a tube or drop shot, you got one single hook, what finds its mark. With these, you gotta make sure, because they clamp down, you gotta set. I got him right here, but his other fish, right, boom, they clamp down on it. You gotta make sure that two things. You use the right rod. The glass rod's great because it's got the properties where it gives. So the fish can grab the bait, turn, you set, you don't pull it away. The Legend Glass 7.2, medium power, catching me some medium bass.